First, I would like to request His Excellency Mr. Sujan Chinoy, Ambassador of India to Japan, to give the welcoming remarks to the students, please.
It's very clear that I have a booming voice. It do not require Welcome, Ambassador Megata, and welcome to each one of you to the Embassy of India in Tokyo. It's been nearly a year since my old friend, Professor Megata, now and formerly Ambassador Megata, proposed to me that he would like to bring students of the Chuo University across to the Indian Embassy for interaction, and I very heartily welcome that idea. And after that first successful interaction here at the Embassy, I was also invited to visit Chuo University for a lecture. And I did go there. I don't know if some of you were present at that lecture. I'm greatly encouraged by the fact that this is now developing into a regular feature of Professor Megata's classes, that is to bring his students across to the Indian Embassy for some interaction. I think one of the most important challenges before every country today is to ensure that their youth know a great deal more than they do about the outside world. For the youth is the future of any country. You are the generation that will propel Japan into the truly into the 21st century. We in India understand better than anybody else the challenges before the youth, for we are one of the most youthful countries in the world, with more than 50% of our population below the age of 25 years. We live in a very different century in the 21st century from that of the past, that is the 20th century. The world has changed dramatically in the last few years. Even though it may appear that globalization is on the retreat, I personally believe that globalization is like a genie. Once it's been let out of the bottle, you cannot put it back into the bottle. It is here to stay. In India, in Buddhism, which unites us, for Buddhism came out of India and spread to East Asia, including Japan. In that great religion, there is a story of the five blind men and the elephant, and how each blind man is groping and feeling a part of the elephant without knowing what that entity truly is. And each one describes that particular entity in a different manner.
インドと日本はですね、その古くして起こった、そしてあの、イ 東アジア、日本を含む東アジアに伝わってきた仏教という偉大な宗教で結ばれておりますけれども、この仏教に一つのお話がありまして、これはですね、5人の目が見えない人たちがその像を触ってみるという話です。で、その目の見えない人たちがですね、それぞれ像の違う部分をですね触って、まあ、こういう形をしている、ああいう形をしているというふうに言い合う話なんですけれども、
The one who felt the legs said it's a tree trunk. The one that felt the trunk said it's a rope. And each one said something different. So also today, there is a differing perception of the globalized world in which we live.
足を触った人ではですね、まあ、これはそのなんか木の幹のようなものだと言いました。そして鼻を触った人です。これはロープのようなものだと言いました。なので、グローバライゼーションといってもですね、世界のグローバライゼーションといってもですね、人によってその見方が違うわけです。
Globalization today is accompanied by a pushback of nationalism and trade protectionism.
グローバライゼーションというのは負の要素もありまして、それはですね、一つはですね、ナショナリズムの台頭、もう一つはですね、その貿易の保護主義です。
The services sector around the world, which thrives on the movement of people, is encumbered and hindered by suspicion about immigration and about foreigners. The march of technology, it lives under the shadow of the misuse of technology. We have seen that in cybersecurity threats, in financial fraud, in all kinds of inappropriate activities as a result of the emergence of technology, particularly artificial intelligence and the Internet of Things.
Technology の交流というのはですね、その影の部分もありまして、その安全が脅かされてしまうというところ、またはですね、その金融のその詐欺というようなことが起きてくるわけです。特にですね、人工知能やそしてインターネットビジネス、IoT のテクノロジーなどで発展としてですね、こういった負の要素も起こってきています。
And the requirements of development and connectivity, the requirements of economic growth and prosperity is fundamental to every country.And those that don't have the resources often have to borrow capital from others. Here also, there is the risk of creating needless dependencies on the part of those that borrow.
こういった開発の問題、国の開発の問題、発展の問題、そして接続性、そして経済成長、そして繁栄などを求める国にはですね、さまざまな条件がありまして、その資金がですね、そのリソースが足りないという国も多々あります。ここでですね、とある大国のようなその存在にですね、必要以上に依存してしまうというリスクが出てきます。
So we today live in a world in which countries like India and Japan with shared values.Are looking to show a correct way forward for countries of the Indo-Pacific and countries of our region. A path in which everybody is treated as equal, a path in which there is equal access for every country to the shared commons, to the great maritime environment of the Indo-Pacific, and a future in whichWe are able to build a broader consensus in which differences do not necessarily become disputes and contest does not necessarily result in conflict.
私たちはですね、今日本とインドは共有する価値をたくさん持っている国ですけれども、こういった私たちのような国がですね、このインド太平洋におけるその様々な国にですね、将来に向かっていく正しいやり方というのを示していかなければなりません。それはですね、すべての人がその平等にその生きられる道、みんながですね、シェアドコモンというその共通するその、リソースとかですね、そういったものに平等なアクセスができること、そしてその海洋のその環境などにでも、海洋資源などにでもですね、こういった平等なアクセスができること、そしてその 違いというのがですね、その紛争に結びつかないようなそういった未来を作っていかなければならない。
So it is under this broad overarching theme of a convergence in strategic and economic matters between India and Japan that we are seeking to strengthen and further consolidate our special strategic and global partnership.
Japan and India are
Briefly put, in recent years our relations have developed in a remarkable fashion. Our economic relations are very strong today, with growing investments from Japan into India.At the political level, we have very good understanding between the leaderships of the two countries. This year, we are looking to receiving our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, to Japan for the annual summit.
今年は、インドのナレンドラ・モディ首相が、毎年行っている年次首脳会談のために日本にいらっしゃる場面です。
This kind of a mutually beneficial relationship between two friends, like India and Japan, is strongly supported at the level of parliamentarians, industrialists, captains of industry, academicians, as well as the people at large.
このようなですね、インドというその友人同士の国がですね、さらにですね、お互いに利益を生む関係を持っています。この関係はですね、2国の、その国会議員、そしてビジネスリーダー、そして、研究者や学者の皆さん、そして、一般の人々の支持を得ています。
I will end my brief remarks by once again emphasizing the importance of the youth.
最後にですね、その若者の皆さんの重要性というのを強調して、
It is the leadership of the future that will determine the course and fate of not only our bilateral ties, but also the fate of the region in the future. As we speak,We have invited, the embassy has invited as guests of the government of India, 5 young parliamentarians from Japan, led by Mr. Koizumi Jr. I hope they will see the rapid changes emerging in India,The pace at which the social, political, and economic aspirations of the 1.2 billion people of India are being achieved. And I hope they bring back a certain message for the youth of this country as well.
このですね、若い国会議員の皆さんが今、インドで急速に起きている変化、そしてですね、この12億という人口の、このインド人がですね、この野心を抱いている。その経済的野心、そして政治的野心、そして経済的野心がどのようなその急なペースで実現しつつあるか、これを見ていただいてですね、ぜひ日本の若者たちにメッセージを持って帰ってほしいと思っています。
With these few words, I once again extend a very warm welcome to each one of you at this interactive session at the Embassy of India in Tokyo, and of course, very warm words of welcome to my colleague Ambassador Negata.
そして最後に皆様、インド大使館にようこそいらっしゃいました。そして、目方先生もようこそいらっしゃいました。
There will be some more presentations to follow, and I hope they address your curiosity as well.
これからプレゼンテーションが続きますけれども、皆様の興味に合ったものだといいなと期待しております。
どうもありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。